Hello chess fans, today I have a wonderful attacking game by world champion Boris Baski against grandmaster Larry Evans. This game was played many years ago at the Chess Olympics, and with the white pieces here plays Boris Baski. He storms with his h-pawn and attacks the black king. According to the rule, if you are attacked at the wing, then do something in the center. Maybe this was the reason for this move of black. He takes on e4, but Boris Baski isn't interested in any pawns or material things. He storms again with his h-pawn, and now black takes again, grabs a pawn. Now white opens the h-file, and black has to take with the h-pawn. Because of this strong bishop, he can't take back with the f-pawn, it's pinned. Now a typical attacking move, bishop h6. It is a typical move because he wants to exchange the strongest defender of the black king, the bishop, on g7. Black takes again. And now the rook is attacked, and rook h4 improves the rook even more. Knight attacks the bishop on h6, takes, takes, and now queen takes finally a pawn on g2 and joins the king side in the attack. Knight h6, the knight was kind of hanging. Knight f3. A real good attacker plays with all of his pieces, all light or minor pieces, and all heavy pieces should join the attack. Knight f5 attacks the rook again, but this rook stays on the h-file and will be soon doubled with his colleague. Queen d6, knight e5, he jumps into a good square. And this sets up a little trap if black wants to defend on the h-file. White can simply take, exchange the rooks, and make a fork and win the queen. That's why black can't play rook h8. He instead finally developed one piece. The whole queen side was sleeping so far, and another strong move, a centralizing knight move with tempo. The queen is attacked, has to retreat. Now the other rook joins the h-file. This is the time for taking a photo. All these white pieces are in the attack. A wonderful position for an attacker. Black is 2 pawns up, but this is too much firepower. The king will not survive this many threats and power of white. He played rook g8. What was the reason for this move? He wants to escape with the king, and white will have this check on the 7th rank. The king flees. White has another check on f7, but is now the king safe? No, it isn't safe, because white has a very strong tactical move, a fancy move, and I'm sure Spassky had a lot of fun. Can you see the move? It is a queen sacrifice. He played queen g6. If the rook takes, he will be checkmate, because both rooks and this knight prepared this checkmate mechanism. So Evans tried another move, it's knight e5, but it doesn't help, because now there follows a very strong double check. And after this super strong move, black resigned. Because it's a double check, black's king is limited. He can't take the queen because it's a double check. And he can't take this rook with the rook. He only can take here on f8. But now, because of this bishop, it's a checkmate, queen g8. Or after this double check, he can escape via d7. But now there are four checkmates. Such a strong position, so many checkmates. Number one, checkmate number two, checkmate number three, and even checkmate number four with a knight. And this was a fantastic victory, a fantastic attacking game by the world champion Boris Baski. And I hope you liked this game as I did. Thanks for watching, guys, and I see you in the next video.